Around 45 minutes to 1 hour. So 1 hour, this was broadcasted worldwide. So this will help you to understand how to find out the journal is fake or not. Also, I have published a couple of papers. It's coming in the library, High Tech News, Emerald Publishing. It will be available online the next month. Again, that is to find out if a journalist hijacked or not using Scopus and other databases. Few other references that I am sharing, which will have list of hijacked journals, list of original websites, and list of duplicate websites. And summary of the talk is, again, two things: save your money, save your research paper, and avoid hijack and fake journals. I'll just take two more slides. I'll just put in recently, to share information on retraction notices recently. So retraction, this is, I want to share because this scenario is increasing in large, at a very rapid rate at recently. That is, people are publishing the research papers, copying from other researchers, and they get their paper published in Elsevier top journals, IEEE top journals, and they're satisfied. But now what is happening is that every paper is going through a research, okay, by the editor-in-chief, and they are trying to find if any possible level of plagiarism is involved, okay. So when it is found out, the author is informed, the co-authors are informed, and after that, what happens is IEEE retraction notices. Okay, this will remain. So the author names will be there. Title paper, notice of IEEE violation principles. Retraction notice will be published by IEEE, which I feel will be a big problem to the professor, or it will harm the professor in a big way. So Bentham Science retraction notice. Recent Elsevier Science 2019 retraction notice. So the article has been retracted, and down it will be clearly stated that this article has been copied from some other article. So this is a big mistake everyone is doing. Everyone is trying to get their paper published, but please make sure that the papers are not plagiarized. Otherwise, even after publication, I'm saying, once you publish also, there is a lot of chances that the paper will be scanned through a lot of new algorithms, in the artificial intelligence algorithms, deep learning and neural networks. Everything is being used by the publishing agencies to find out how many papers are being plagiarized, even to the level of figures as well as equations. Everything is being found out. If something is found out, retraction notice will be sent. So my kind request that every researcher should publish their papers and should check whether their papers are plagiarized or not. I went fast because we had only 30 minutes. And it's again lunch time. Thank you so much, and I would appreciate if there are a couple of questions, I'd be happy to.
You will send the link to us.
Yes, definitely.
That's very important.
Sure. Yeah.
Thank you for the presentation.
My pleasure.
How is the hijacked journal different from the predatory journal?
Yes.
How is it different?
Many people find it hijacked journals are legitimate journals for which a duplicate website is created. So hijacked journals normally are high, people target high impact factor journals, because we will never publish in a journal that is not having an impact factor or not in Scopus or some other kind of thing, because that is a standard level. So people try to create a duplicate website of hijacked journals and create this fake websites. Now predatory journals, they wouldn't have achieved a level, that is, they might not have got into Scopus, or they might not have got into SEA indexing or impact factor indexing. But those journals are what you say as low quality journals. So we can differentiate predatory publishers and predatory journalists as low quality journals that would publish your research without proper review. Okay, and hijacked journals are completely fake journals. That is, they are fake websites. These are low quality websites.
So a hijacked journal will have an official website and a fake website.
Yes.
Where a predatory journal will have just one website.
Yes.
But both of them are charging exorbitant fees.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's correct.
Excellent.
Yeah. Yes, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Okay, I've got the experience last year. I sent my paper to the, I'm not sure the name, original. And they make it closed. Mm-hmm. And then the genome is closed. Is it the considered as the
what is closed, ma'am?
The genome. The genome is closed.
Okay. Then we need to, for every suspicious journal, so whenever there's actually, there's a publisher known as Cabells. Cabells is one of the famous publishers. They have come up with a journal whitelist, journal blacklist. Okay, that the problem with that list is, that is available for a payment.